So let's start from the beginning.
Okay.
Your life is here.
My
Nashville.
Life is here.
And
yes,
it's been here for a long
time. It's been
here
for 14 years this summer.
Okay, I just have to know, at what point in your life did you and your husband say, we just have to move to Nashville?
You know what it was? My husband was doing music here. He was in a country group called Blue County, and he was sort of traveling all over the United States on a bus, and the kids would jump on the bus with him. They were having so much fun. And I had sort of been working so much at that point that I just felt like, wow, I feel burned out. I feel like we're not together, like we just need our family together. So we made this decision, like my contract was coming up and I was like, oh, I'm so scared, you know, and I was like, I'm not gonna resign and we're moving to another state. And literally, like we were waiting for our house in California to sell the week that we packed it up and moved here, and it sold and we never looked back. And we just thought, what a great change of pace for our kids. Like we literally moved to the country. We had goats, we had horses. They were out 6 o'clock in the morning feeding goats,
wow.
You know, fishing for crawdads in holes right in our front yard. And so these are like these California kids,
yeah.
Like living
LA
country
kids.
Life. LA kids, yeah, not even California, LA kids, city kids. And we never looked back. And we still have family there,
yeah.
So we go back, but we love country life, love it. We've never changed our mind.
How old were your kids when you moved here?
9 and 14.
Wow.
Our daughter was just starting high school, which we probably should have thought about. What a hard transition, like. And her
and
friends told her,
too.
Yeah, totally. And her friends told her, they're like, yeah, we knew there was like this California girl coming into our school. I was like, wow, Emily, you did good. That's a lot of pressure. But they were so sweet. And then our son, now we figured out he's been more of a Tennessean than a Californian because he was only 9 and now he's 21.
Right.
So, yeah.
I have to tell you on Instagram, I don't know when you posted this, but I guess recently, somewhat recently in the past, you had said there's a problem when you post more pictures of your cows than of your kids.
Yes.
I loved that post.
How sad is that?
It made me laugh. It made me laugh because you've embraced this whole homesteading life.
Oh my goodness. We love it. When we got our cows, we were like, oh, well, we need to like have a relationship with the cows. And this farmer was like, no, they're just cows. Like they're gonna eat. And we're like, no, we're gonna buy them cookies and they're gonna be like our dogs. And this guy was looking at us like, yeah, these Californians, they come here and buy these animals. No joke, we were feeding our cows cookies out of our hands. Total cows who had no contact with people, they're eating them out of our hands.
Isn't it like the Kobe beef that those cows get massages and get fed Japanese beer? Do you give your
cows
right. massages?
We pet them all the time. They're amazing, amazing.
Well, if you think about it, they're giving you so much,
yes.
Right? So you make them happy, they're happy cows.
It's incredible. Like they would run down the driveway because they knew they were gonna get sweet feed, which we probably gave them more than they're supposed to have. But you know, it's just part of it. But we love it.
At what point in your career did you realize that you really needed a break?
You know, it is the best job in the world. It's just sometimes you go, okay, there's priorities in life and your family has to be your first priority. And my husband and I were both working so much and we just thought, we have these two amazing kids and we only get them for this amount of time and we both can't be working. And I was so ready to just take a little break, as much as I loved my job, but I thought I can't always put my job first. And my boss is the greatest man in the world because he let me come back again after I left. And I was like, oh my goodness, when does this happen? So I just always feel like family's priority and you have to do what you need to do for the four of you to be together.
Well, don't you think though what you're talking about is a testament to not only the role that you play on
mm-hmm.
what a huge show,
oh,
right?
My goodness.
But also the person that you are, that they would say to you that you are able to come back.
Amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, really, I feel, I was so young when I started, I had no idea really what Days of Our Lives was. And I just, really within the past 10 years, I've gone, I have been a part of this iconic television show and it's really just been my whole life, and I probably haven't appreciated it as much as I should have because it has been this incredible career.
Yeah, I mean,
incredible.
Who gets to do that? I feel like other than people who work in right. daytime television and soap operas,
yeah.
I mean, you work job to job. You might play
yeah.
a role as an actor for
right.
a season or maybe a film.
Right.
But you've played the same role
yeah.
for 34 years.
34 years. And our show has been on television on NBC for 54 years this year. I know, it's incredible. We may be the longest running TV show. I would have to look into that, but yeah. we may be. We're close.
At what point in your career did you say, I am this person is me, this Jennifer Horton
right.
character, I've become her?
Well, it's really funny. When I first started, I was 18 years old, just turned 18. I was like really still right out of New Jersey, really feisty, really. And I had like these really sweet, pure storylines. And I was like, what is this? This is so unrealistic. I can't even believe I'm playing this storyline. It's like, so good, and she's so good. And I was so rebellious about it. And then as I got older, I was like, oh no, that was a good thing. Why didn't I appreciate that? I had this really, you know, and then having Francis and Mac as Tom and Alice, mm-hmm. they were like real grandparents to me. So they really, you know, showed me the ropes and shaped me and molded me and showed me the importance of being a part of the Horton family and how sweet that was yeah. and what a responsibility and just imitating this incredibly flawed family, but incredibly strong family.
But really, when you think about it, if you hadn't have had such a pure storyline,
mm-hmm.
I feel like that character
yeah.
would have gotten killed off a long time
You're
ago.
Right. You're so right. I really, and being part of the Horton family was such an honor, and I had no idea. And I went, wow, I'm on this show, Days of Our Lives, and people seem really excited that I'm a Horton? Like, what does this all mean? And only now can I go, wow, I have been a Horton for most of my life.
Yeah.
And what an honor.
Well, you've
and
been a
blessing.
Horton longer than.
Yeah,
than you,
seriously.
Than you've been a Reeves.
Yeah. You know, Kristen Alfonso, she plays Hope on the show. We, every time we're in a set together, we look at each other. We were just working together last week and we go, we are still here. This is crazy.
Yeah.
Like, we've known each other longer than we've known most people
right.
in our life.
Well, and then you became a Devereaux, and
yeah.
you became part of
yeah.
a power couple, a super couple.
Super couple,
which,
yes.
I mean, that's got to be a gift, too, because,
the
again,
best.
I mean, you're talking about longevity
yeah.
and
yeah,
job security.
Oh, my goodness. And, you know, it's so hard when you, you know, they try to, you know, have you work with so many people to find that thing that works. And I remember when Matt and I started working together, they had no intention of making us a couple. They just
really?
Wanted to give Jennifer a job at the newspaper. But we started working together and they kind of saw this thing where he was a little bit older than her and she kind of didn't really put up with his thing. And they were like, wait, this could work. And so they had not really planned on doing that. And then it totally worked. And here Matt and I are now, all these years later, working together again. And it's like we just slid right back into it.
Sure.
It's been so fun.
Well, I love that you've taken these different hiatuses
mm-hmm.
and you've come back all
yeah.
of these different times. And then
yeah.
Matt, too.
I know.
As well, taking a hiatus because he was dead and then
I know.
Now he's not dead. And
yeah.
That's incredible.
You never really die on daytime. I mean, you know, you dig your way out of that pit. Everybody finds their way out.
So I want to hear about kind of your day-to-day. How
mm-hmm.
long are you shooting for? How often are you going back and forth? All of that.
Well, we work just... because television's different and the economy is different, we shoot 3 weeks on and 1 week off. So in 15 days, 15 days of 3 weeks, we do almost 9 shows a week. So
oh my gosh.
It's unbelievable. We do, I don't know, 80 scenes a day. So it's a day, and sometimes we do 2 and 3 shows at a time. So sometimes we'll go in and you'll have like 20 scenes in a row with all dialogue.
How do you even memorize your
lines?
How do you do
I
that?
I think there's just the pressure of going, we have to do it. We really don't have a choice. So somehow we do it and we just go, oh, but the best part is we get a week off at the end of the month, you know? So that's, you go, yeah, wouldn't everybody like to have a week off at the end of the month, you know? So we'll pound out these 20 scenes a day.
Wow.
So it's a pretty intense schedule. But like I said, you know, we've been working together for years with all of these people and it really is my second family.
Mm-hmm. What time in the daytime do you start? When do you end?
We,
at the end of the day?
We start about 6:15, 6:30 a.m. But the beauty in this is that if you're in the same set and all your scenes are in that set, you could be done before lunchtime.
Oh.
And be done and then go home and start studying for the next day. So and then there's an afternoon shift. You might be in both shifts, or you might be in one or the other. So it's random every week, but for 3 weeks straight, we kind of knock them out fast.
I can see why you'd get burned out, because I imagine that's just...
And then having little ones, yeah, and having kids and wanting to be their mom and wanting to make dinner every night. You know, you're like, oh, I don't want to miss this, but I have this incredible job. But like I said, we have this great boss who's like, yeah, it's okay, I get it.
Yeah.
You know, you need to have your family too.
But it is a testament to the job that you're doing, because if you were you were hard to work with,
yeah,
or
for
if
sure.
you didn't do well when you were shooting scenes, if you would always forget your lines, if you didn't study,
you're right.
if you didn't prepare, they wouldn't extend
you're right.
that to
it's
you.
It's like if you want to be part of the family, be part of the family. You know what I mean? And then our boss is so gracious. He's like, you want to be part of the family? He has brought so many people on that just been like, I'd love to be on your show. Okay, come on. You know, come be part of the family. I know. He's wonderful.
So tell me about hair and makeup.
Hair and makeup is amazing. Obviously, you can tell by my hair today that I had to do it myself. And all I know is a flat iron. So to sweet Marisa, who does my hair, she would be appalled right now. But you get to see it on the show,
I
and
do.
It's all done. And
it's slicked back, which I'm always amazed
like,
by that.
She has so many tricks, and she uses like these beautiful, teeny little brushes that look like a toothbrush, and she puts all this product on it and like sweeps it on your hair, and then like literally brushes pieces at a time in place. And she's just phenomenal. And she takes care of it, and then I'm like sleeping in the chair with my head like this, and she's still doing my hair. And hair and makeup is my favorite part of the whole day. It's like being in a spa for an hour and a half.
And that's
amazing.
What is amazing to me. You spend 90 minutes.
Yeah.
And so if anyone ever looks at you on TV and says, gosh, she looks so great.
90 minutes. I always said if any of us were brave enough to take a picture of ourselves when we walk in there in the morning, which none of us have been brave enough yet, and walk out of there, it's literally, you wouldn't believe we were the same people.
And don't you feel
it's
like
amazing.
People love before and afters?
Oh,
so
yeah.
So if you did a before and after.
Yeah, we should just be brave enough to do it.
Some people are, and that's the younger people. I feel like
as we all
get older,
for sure.
It's like, my skin doesn't look the same.
Totally.
I'm not doing that.
Yeah, if I was like 20, I'd be like, yeah, come on, before and after, not now.
What do you think people ask you the most when they see you around town?
I think they're always surprised that we live here, you know, and that we live so far out of town in the country. And I think they're always surprised that we commute a lot. But otherwise, you know, Nashville is a special place. And I think that's why we moved here, because we just thought, is this place for real? Like, everybody is really nice.
Yeah.
And everybody just seems really relaxed. And nobody's, like, trying to run you off the road. And it just felt really like a community. And we moved here, and it was absolutely true. Every single part of it was true.
What do you think about the change over these last few years Nashville as a city has been making?
I know. I think it's wonderful for Nashville. I think it's great that everyone is seeing what we saw. But then you go, oh, no, not too many more people, you know? I mean, but I get it. I get it, because it's what we felt. And I just think it's great if you can come here and just love what this place is about and don't try to change it, because it's sweet. There's a sweetness about it, and you don't ever want that to go away.
Do you see yourself ever leaving Nashville?
No, we are set. My husband and I are like, you know, we are out in the country. Mm-hmm. We are in heaven. If we never had to leave the house, we would be happy with all of our animals. Our kids are grown. Both of our kids got married this year.
Oh,
so
congratulations.
Thank you. It's been a fun year, but we're loving country life.
Who takes care of all of your animals when you're away?
Well, we usually work it out that my husband and I are always here, but our kids are great. They're like, we'll come stay at the house and take care of the animals. So
wonderful.
It's like a little escape for them out of town.
So if somebody feeds the cows Twizzlers, maybe it'll be okay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. They are spoiled. We have
a bunch
of spoiled animals, I'm telling you.
Well, it's been a wonderful time.
Thank
you. I love
you.
Talking to you.
Oh, you too. I've loved meeting you.
Yes. Well, love you haven't heard anything about me. We'll tell
I
you
know.
About
well, that's the
off.
Next interview.
That's right.
We'll flip the cameras.
Well, thanks.
Thank you. I think